Welcome to Outdoor Adventures with Jason. Each week, I bring the world of hunting, fishing, and conservation to you. From the great hunting and fishing opportunities found in the Americas to the dream safaris located on the dark continent beyond, I'll introduce you to those who are already out in the field living every outdoor enthusiast dream, as well as outfitters and gear manufacturers that can make those dreams your reality. All right, on this episode of Outdoor Adventures with Jason, I've been able to catch up here at the Dallas Safari Club show with Jason Price of The Experience. How you doing, Jason?
Doing great, Jason. How are you?
Not too bad. It's the Jason squared.
Yeah, I got a lot of Jasons in here.
So tell me, how are you doing at this show? Anything catch your eye for a hunt?
There's a lot of things that'll catch your eye in here. It's pretty fantastic.
I need a huge increase on my credit card here, a huge credit limit increase.
Yeah, my credit card company knows this time of year to cut me back, actually.
They put you on an automatic automatic stay.
I go down to $100 increments.
Your wife takes care of that.
Yeah, absolutely.
So tell me, you've got any interesting hunts coming up?
We do. We have a hunt that the Dallas is going to be leaving on Monday to film with a good friend of ours, Chris Geikema, out in New Mexico with Compass West Outfitters. He and Dan are going to go out and try to get a big elk. So that's a pretty exciting hunt coming up. And then we have a desert bighorn hunt January 18th. So excited about that hunt as well.
Man, so this is going to be your first desert bighorn?
It is.
Probably your only one?
Well, you know, you never know. The sheep bug is pretty contagious, and I have been consumed by trying to get sheep, so I'm not so sure if it'll be the first, but I don't know if it'll be the last.
Does this finish a Grand Slam?
No, this will be the second of four, so I'm still a long ways away.
Okay, so you still got a little room to go.
Yeah, I'm just actually trying to catch up with Dan, which is just now joining us.
Now
he's already got two, and I'm one, so once again, I'm chasing Catlin.
So this is Dan Catlin of the Wildlife Gallery and hashtag Chasing Price.
That's right.
And,
thank you.
With Jason Price, we got hashtag Chasing Catlin. So we got quite the game going on here.
Well, the reality of it is Jason has shot, like, I think it's somewhere in the neighborhood of 28 or 30 leopards by now. He's been to Africa somewhere around 50 times. I might embellish a little bit when I talk about Jason, but that's just my normal MO. So I shoot one more sheep than this guy, and he's been chasing me ever since.
Well, now, if anybody goes out to Dan, if anybody goes out to your social media page on Facebook, they'll see your living room. I think you shot more than one sheep.
Wait till Jason Price gets his trophy room in. Yeah. It's going to
be. Well, it's funny you say that. We just moved into a new house, and we're working really closely with the Wildlife Gallery with getting a mountain scene built in there as well. But I keep telling everyone that ask about, well, how's the trophy room going? Right now it looks like Noah's Ark had a crash. There are animals laying on the floor everywhere. But it doesn't really matter how many I have in there, because I do in my mind know it's one less than Dan.
Yeah, the boat did crash into your living room.
Yeah.
You're right.
Well, this is something else, Dan. The gallery you've got set up here, you guys have got Jason in here with you, and Dallas is running around, and I can see Nevada over here. So you guys have just got an amazing setup here.
Yeah, you know, I think every business model or good business model really revolves around the type of people you surround yourself with. And I think at the Wildlife Gallery, we've been very blessed to not only surround ourselves with great artists, but in the industry, people like Jason Price and Dallas Haymeyer, and of course Nevada Grassi joining our team with his talents of skull carving and just artistic talent altogether. It would have been an interesting thing for you to see us set this booth up with all of the artistic flow that goes on in people's eyes, and I really think it came out good because we didn't know exactly where things would go, but it, you know, you got a lot of people.
Oh, this isn't good, this is great.
Well, thank you.
Yeah, it's something hard to describe. I mean, it's almost like hunting, or a hunting trip that you go on and you come back home and you try to describe to them what that trip was like or that experience was like. And same thing in here. We can't verbally describe to you how impressive this is. The artistic ability that these guys have at the Wildlife Gallery is why I'm a strong believer in it. But it's very evident here at the Dallas Safari Club.
Oh, this I saw last night. I was watching a video you guys put out, Facebook Live video, and in part of it, well, first there was the video about y'all texting like young girls.
Yeah.
That cracked me up.
My wonderful wife, Charlotte.
But this amazing bear behind you with the water, I don't think I've ever seen a mount done like that before.
Yeah, and it's unbelievable. People come by this one and they take photos and stand in front of it. It's probably the most photogenic piece in the entire Dallas Safari Club.
You're
and
right.
Dan will tell you a little bit more about the artist that did it, which is, It's an unbelievable concept and idea.
Yeah, I certainly have to give a shout out to our designer and trophy room designer, Frank Neumeyer, who is another one of those people we have brought into our team, surrounding ourselves with great people. But Frank's got great vision, and he's got great ability to pull off the vision. He and his team right now are currently working on a two-bear fighting scene with a splash similar to this, fighting over a fish. And we're going to have that at, in Salt Lake City, Utah, at the Western Hunting Expo coming up here next month. And so I promise you, this kind of sounds cliche, but it's going to make a splash, this scene.
They all do it. You know, and you've got the episode coming out tonight of the moose.
Right.
That Jason and this one is should be a real special episode to watch. If anybody's not gone out to the experience to catch the first episode with Doll Sheep, or was it Stone? No, Doll Sheep.
Yeah.
So that's great. And then, Dan, you've got some episodes that are going to start airing on the experience as well, correct?
Right. We're blessed to have quite a bit of content. Some content that was filmed with the experience, and then also some content with my role on Trigicon's World of Sports Afield. We've worked a deal to get some of that content, some of my most favorite hunts, so we can, we can also highlight those. But you're going to see a whole lot of programming in an epic way presented to all of our viewers out there.
Oh, very cool.
So tonight we have the Moose episode coming, which is episode 2, and we had a kind of a bonus feature in the middle there. Dallas was able to film an unbelievable sheep hunt in Utah that ended up being the number 2 sheep taken in Utah. And then after the moose hunt, we'll have Dan's desert bighorn hunt. And then there's another hunt coming up pretty soon. That's Dan's Doll Sheep Hunt, and a lot of people have probably already seen that hunt. But it's worth redoing it and putting it on the experience platform, because it's like my Doll Sheep Hunt. It's a very emotional hunt. And to be honest, it kind of lit the fire in me for, you know, what I'm doing sheep hunting. So we can't wait to re-air some of Dan's stuff and put our own little twist and spin on it. And hopefully the viewers really like it. I know they will.
Now, your Doll Sheep film started off first on the Trigicon World.
That's correct. Yeah, a couple years ago, actually. But like Jason said, it really sparked something in us. I think him and I have grown in the hunting world, in the mountains, and the challenge hunting together. We've had a friendship for a long time, but I mean, I don't want to get soft and all that kind of stuff, but it is kind of soft. We have a soft heart for hunting. We have a soft heart for the experience. We didn't know what the name of this was going to be. We didn't know we would end up together in partnership on these things. But because of our passion for hunting, the outdoors, sharing it with friends and family, and our heart for the animals that we pursue, we just been drawn together with this whole project, and I couldn't be more excited about where it's headed.
Well, that's great, and again, thank you guys for your time. I know we've got a lot going on here at the booth, and you guys have got a lot that you're taking care of. You got nonstop people coming in, and it's just Thursday.
Yeah,
this weekend
great.
Is going to be crazy.
Yes, going to
so
be great.
It's good to catch up with your past clients, your current clients.
Yes.
And so, man, I wish you guys all the best. I'm going to get Nevada here on a live Facebook live here thing to show some of the sculpting that he's doing,
yes.
The carving that he's doing.
That guy is unbelievable. And as talented as he is, he's that good of a person.
Yeah.
He's really a good guy.
Great guy, very humble, our kind of guy here at the Experience and the Wildlife Gallery. We're really, really proud to have him.
Well, fantastic. Well, enjoy the Dallas heat.
Yes.
Because you're headed back to some cold weather.
That's all right. That breaks us in for the upcoming hunting
season.
That's
right.
There you go.
That's right. Thank you.
You'll be able to run through the snow barefoot.
That's right. Thanks a lot, Jason.
All right. Thank you,
Jason.
Guys.